quiet down for morning prayer. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Smile in the face of trouble. Don't waste your time wishing all your problems away. In this world, you will have problems. That's just the way it is here. But rejoice and be thankful. Why? Because you're my child, and that means you have an eternity of problem-free living waiting for you in heaven. No one can take that awesome future away from you. And while you are here on earth, I will equip you for whatever troubles come your way. Start each day by asking for my help. Tell me everything that is worrying you, and I will guide you through your troubles. I promise. Try to see problems as I see them. Challenges that you and I can handle together. Challenges that will make you stronger. Remember, together you and I can do anything. Even smile in the face of trouble. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Amen. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. God is good. All the time. And all the time, God is good. Please stand for the Pledge of Allegiance. Ready, begin.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Please be seated.
Good morning, Cougars.
Good morning. Today is Thursday, and today second grade is going to the Choral Festival.
That's exciting, and sixth grade has a study trip to Into the Woods.
Wow, I bet so that's going to be an awesome play to get to see.
Yeah, I bet you've seen the movie, and that was really good, so the play will probably be even better.
Yeah, I bet it will. I bet they're going to have an awesome time.
Yeah.
And since it is Star Wars week, we have a couple more facts to share with you guys. The first one is that the Tatooine town in Episode 4, A New Hope, is still in Tunisia today, but if you want to visit it, you would probably want to go pretty soon because it is slowly being buried by sandstorms.
Wow, I kind of want to see that. That's cool that they just kept it there.
That's weird to think that in just a little while it's going to be completely gone.
Yeah, that's kind of sad. But in The Empire Strikes Back, on the ice planet Hoth, most scenes were filmed right outside their hotel because there's a blizzard that just hit.
Wow, that must have been a very cold place to stay.
Yeah.
But it worked out. Then they just got to film right outside the hotel.
Yeah, they probably didn't really. They just walked out of their hotel and there it was.
Absolutely. Here is Brian with the birthdays.
Hey, Cougars. Today we've got a birthday. Tell us your name, what you want, and how old you're turning.
My name is Amelia. I'm turning 6, and I want no homework.
That's a very good wish. Now let's dance. Here's Tessa with the Bible verse.
Hey, Cougars. The Bible verse of the month for May is, "Though I fall, I will rise. The Lord will be my light." Micah chapter 7, verse 8. Now you may ask, what does it mean? The Bible verse of May means that we must not only look to the Lord, but to look for him. In our greatest distresses, we shall see no reason to despair of salvation, if by faith we look to the Lord as our God of salvation. We may join hope in God's mercy and remain faithful and trusting. Even when we sin, God forgives us and accepts us, as long as we try to become better. The Lord shows us the way and creates a path for us to lead to him. Rise up, Cougars. Apply the Bible verse of May to your daily life. Here is the Disciples of the Month.
The TK Disciple of the Month is Michael Corona.
Michael arrives each morning with a huge smile
Michael tries his very best with every lesson and project. He shows patience with his friends and is very caring. Michael participates so much more now, and he is confident. When I greet him goodbye, he always gives me a hug. Michael is a loving young man and wants others to know that he cares about them. Michael, we are so proud of you. You have grown so much this year in TK. Keep walking with Jesus.
The disciple of the month for kindergarten is Alisa Zuniga.
Alisa is a nice, sweet, and quiet girl that demonstrates reverence, respect, and responsibility. Alisa is also a hard worker and always tries to do her best in everything she does. When it comes to class assignments and projects, she follows directions very carefully and completes her assignments in a neatly manner. When coming into class, she is the first to sit quietly with her hands folded and is ready to begin class. Alisa is well-liked by her peers and teachers. We are all very proud of her. Keep up the great work.
The first grade disciple of the month is Joseph Esperanza.
Joseph is diligent with his classroom work and his weekly job. Joseph has a calm, kind demeanor and is well-liked by all his peers. He is always willing to help others in the classroom and out on the playground. He follows all classroom expectations and is respectful to all his teachers. Joseph is truly a great example of a disciple of Jesus. First grade is very proud of Joseph.
The second, third, and fourth grade disciples of the month are not here, but they are Preston Mahone, Dylan Garcia, and Ian Brunetti.
Preston has been chosen for disciple of the month for second grade. Preston is kind, intelligent, and caring, and a caring friend to all he comes in contact with. He tries hard to be a disciple of Jesus by following the SLEs whenever he can. Preston has been working hard to learn the Ten Commandments and to truly understand what the meaning of each commandment is. Preston has embraced all that second grade has had to offer him and has shown courage, strength, and gratitude every step of the way. May God shower you with all of his love, today and always.
The disciple of the month for third grade is Dylan Garcia. Over the last few months, Dylan has made great strides in asking for help as needed, which in turn has led to greater academic confidence and success. He is on track to meet his AR goal for this trimester, with already reaching 84% of his goal. Dylan has also worked very hard in memorizing the multiplication facts. He is also kind and friendly to everyone in the classroom and on the playground. I am proud of all Dylan has accomplished this year. Keep up the great work.
The fourth grade disciple of the month is Ian Brunetti. Ian is a well-mannered student who follows the classroom expectations on a daily basis. He is very considerate and friendly to his classmates and has a positive attitude about school. One outstanding quality about Ian is that he works quietly during class time and raises his hand to ask or answer questions. Ian is very neat and organized with his work and shows great penmanship. He is a great role model for others and has truly earned the honor of being the disciple of the month for April. Congratulations, Ian. Keep up the great job in fourth grade.
The fifth grade disciple of the month is Jaden Asuncion.
Jaden is a terrific representation of our school. He is a very polite and respectful young man. He treats all his teachers and classmates with respect. In the classroom, he works hard, participates well, and is kind to all. He completes all his assignments with effort and care. He is not afraid to ask for help or to help others. He is a great classmate to all. Jaden is well known for his artistic ability, and he has a very creative style that truly captures all eyes. We know Jaden will do great things in his future, and we look forward to watching him excel in junior high.
The sixth grade disciple of the month is William Johnson.
William displays a hard work ethic by coming prepared to class each day, as well as often being willing and eager to share his thoughts and ideas with his peers and teachers. He has also exceeded his AR goal both trimesters so far this year, and is well on his way to exceeding it this last trimester as well. William is an amazing role model for his little buddy, always making sure he is following along and understanding how to properly participate during Mass. His teachers appreciate that he often goes above and beyond to lend a helping hand. For example, William helps distribute and collect the walkie-talkies to the staff each day during Carline. It may sound like a small gesture, but William accepted this task without question, and we all appreciate it so very much. Keep up the wonderful work, William, and congratulations on earning our 6th grade Disciple of the Month.
The 7th grade Disciple of the Month is Danielle Narmi.
Danielle has shown tremendous growth this year. She is responsible about turning in her assignments and putting extra study time in to achieve high scores. She has done an excellent job in the third and fourth trimesters in meeting her AR goal. Danielle recently achieved honor roll, and she is determined to do it again. She takes pride in her work and has been very responsible about writing her assignments and practice prep down every day. She asks great questions and participates in class activities. Danielle is also responsible and reverent in her service to the church as an altar server. She represents Sam in cheer and scouts, and she is very active in her efforts to do service in the community. Danielle has had an excellent year, and we are proud of all that she has accomplished.
The Disciple of the Month for 8th grade is Jake Quezada.
Jake has bestowed this honor for many reasons. He has really made a conscious effort to be aware of his classmates and teachers, and it has not gone unnoticed. First, he is responsible with all his schoolwork and supplies and never has an unfinished or missing assignment. Next, Jake is reverent, taking special care of his second grade little buddy during Tuesday school Eucharist, and prays for others as well as with his class during morning and afternoon prayer. He is an active learner and shares his faith with others during religion class. Last, he is especially respectful to his teachers and by volunteering to help them with any tasks. Congratulations, Jake, on earning 8th grade's Disciple of the Month.
Have a fantastic rest of your day.
And if you want the force to be with you, rise up.